Start.
Hello viewers, today in this video I am going to show you a demonstration of how to do a procedure called gable bend. The gable bend is a second order bend which is given in the direction of occlusoincisal direction. Why? Because when there is long extraction spaces, if the extraction space is too high, when we do retraction from the molar to the anterior, when we put an etching, sometimes the anteriors can tend to go for uncontrolled tipping because of the force factors. When you give force, the force will be acting upon the bracket, and actually speaking, the force is supposed to be on the center of resistance, which is almost over here between the canine and the lateral incisor. So what we have to do is, before you do a gable bend, you have to take a 1725 or a 1925 stainless steel wire, have two markings between the central and the lateral, this central and the lateral, mark that space for doing a crimpable hook. The crimpable hook is a C-shaped hook which will actually mimic the center of resistance. It is the closest point to the center of resistance. So for a tooth which is having six, if you see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, this is going to be retracted as a single unit. So the ideal height of the center of resistance will be close to around 5 mm from the point of this wire. So if this is root, for a 6 unit combined tooth, the center of resistance is not in the middle of the root, but rather it is almost 5 to 6 mm from the bracket side. So we have to put a crimpable hook, two hooks we have to put using a crimpable hook plier. Then we have to give a bend in this middle part, because if you don't give a bend, what will happen? I will give a demo of it. Suppose this is my wire and I am doing retraction. What are the chances of happening? If you see, when I am retracting, the force factors can cause unwanted movements, say uncontrolled tipping. The root can come out and the incisal edges can go inside. To avoid that effect, we need bodily movement and controlled tipping. So what we will do in that middle portion of the extracted side, say this is the premolar and this is the canine, and this first premolar extracted side, mark it in the middle and give a bend, a 45 degree bend called gable bend. Once the bend is there, the wire becomes like this and there is no chances of force exertion. With force exertion, force will come from the molar band, that is called line of force, and this is the direction of movement. So you will have a controlled movement or a translatory movement of the whole segment of the anterior, because we are doing en masse retraction. So this is called en masse retraction procedure, and this uses friction mechanics. The wire will slide, the anterior tooth will slide and it will come towards the posterior side. So this is called friction mechanics. So for this, two things are important. One is the crimpable hook which mimics the center of resistance of the anterior segment, which is between the lateral and the central incisors, roughly 5 to 6 mm from the middle portion of the wire. Say this is the wire, from here it is 6 mm, the root is here, so it is close to the center of resistance. The more you are close towards the center of resistance, you will have a very desired effect of tooth movement. The second thing is the gable bend. The gable bend is given, there are three order bends, you know, first order, second order, and third order bend. And gable bend is a second order bend, and it just moves the teeth backwards in a very controlled way. So after this, you have to do the space closure with the help of three techniques you can use for space closure. One is using a etching, and the second method is using a closed coil springs, and the third method is using a module with the ligature wire. So these three are good methods, and you can take the anchorage from the molar bands. The best way is to use a mini implant. If you are not using mini implant and if you want anchorage control, you have to use transpalatal arch. The transpalatal arch is a bar which connects two bands, which will really help in controlled movements. So this is what we have to understand in the retraction part of orthodontics. Thank you and God bless you.